the Senate panel tackling the probe into Mayor Go and illegal pogos in the country sets an executive session for next week. Victoria Tulet now joins us with more details on this. Victoria, over to you. What more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. The Senate Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations, and Gender Equality has set June 5 as the date for the executive session with different government agencies to tackle sensitive information on Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go and illegal Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs. In an interview on Teleradio Servicio this morning, Committee Chair and Deputy Minority Leader Senator Riz Ontivero said they will invite the Department of Justice, the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, and Bureau of Internal Revenue to the meeting. Also invited are intelligence agencies, which told Ontivero that this goes deeper than what has already been revealed in the hearing. According to the senator, included in what we will discuss in the alleged or in the meeting is the alleged surveillance, hacking, and espionage on Philippine government done in Bamban. After the executive session, the committee will have at least one more public hearing. Ontivero said their hearings have not been sidetracked as they look into Go's personal background, since this may link her to illegal POGOs. Yesterday, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian said a Chinese citizen named Wen Yi Lin may be Go's real mother. Lin is a fellow incorporator in the Go family business, 2JJ Farms. According to Gatchalian, Lin also traveled with Go's Chinese father, Jian Dong Go, or Angelito Go, 170 times in the span of 6 years. If Lin is established as Go's biological mother, Ontivero said her Filipino citizenship will no longer have basis, and her election as mayor will be put into question. We are still trying to get the side of Mayor Go. Meanwhile, task force accountability will also be looked into, since senators are perplexed on why it did not report any illegal activities related to the POGOs in Bamban. Carmina?
All right, Victoria, how again was Senator Sherwin Gatchalian able to trace what he calls the real biological mother of the mayor?
This suspected biological mother of Go, Wen Yi Lin, Gatchalian was able to get a hold of the copy of the incorporation papers of the QJJ Farms and saw that Go and her family lived in Valenzuela, and so he asked around, and the residents said that this Wen Yi Lin was introduced to them as Go's mother before. So that's where he is coming from. And since Wen Yi is also part of several companies of the Go family, and since she also traveled with Angelito Go to different places 170 times in the past 6 years, he is a bit, came up with this idea or maybe theory that Lin might actually be Go's mother.
Mm-hmm. All right. But this won't appear in the next session, right? Because the next session will be an executive session. The continuation of this story probably the public will be hearing in the next session after this, which is the last one.
You're not yet sure if the next public hearing will be the last one. That will depend on what will come up in that hearing, but definitely there will be another one after the executive session. As for the information on Wen Yi Lin, also are not sure if she will be discussed in the executive session. Mm-hmm. She might be mentioned, since they are digging into Go's personal life, into her personal background, but definitely she will be brought up in the next public hearing. Gatchalian was asked if Wen Yi Lin will be invited to the next public hearing, and he said that he will recommend it to the chair, who is Ontivero. Mm.
And also, you said a while ago that you have yet to hear from Mayor Alice Go of Bamban Tarlac. When you do reach out to her to ask for any comments on the latest developments, what kind of response do you get, Victoria?
Actually, we have been trying to get her lawyers since last week, since after the public hearing. They have Attorney Stephen David replied to us, saying he is still waiting for the confirmation of Mayor Alice Go. She will give an interview, but after that, they haven't responded to us, even if we have been trying to contact them for a couple of days already.
All right. Very own Victoria Tulet there joining us on the line. Thanks, Victoria. The suspect in the fatal road rage incident in the EDSA Ayala tunnel now behind bars. Police confident they have an airtight case. More from Raya Capulong.
The Philippine National Police has arrested the suspect in the fatal road rage-related shooting incident in Ayala Tunnel in Makati on Tuesday afternoon. According to the PNP, even before the shooting incident, the two vehicles already figured in an altercation on the road which was not captured by CCTV.
So, ayan po yung Innova. Ito po yung Kwan. So, dito pa lang, binaril na niya. Tapos, dire-diretso kasi moving ito, so dire-diretso pa rin. And ito, dito na pumunta. So, parang naghiwalay sila. So, yung sa pagbaril po nito, dito po pumasok sa back ng right. Tapos, tumagas po dito sa yung driver side dito. And then, lumabas po dito sa leg niya.
The driver of the white MPV, Aniceto Mateo, died from his gunshot wound. The vehicle's two other occupants, including a 7-year-old child, were unharmed.
The driver victim sustained gunshot wound, causing his instantaneous death. After sustaining gunshot wounds, the driver of the Toyota Innova managed to maneuver his vehicle to the right corner of EDSA Ayala Tunnel southbound, while his companion sought help from the passing motorist by waving her hands.
With the help of CCTV footage, the suspect was arrested Wednesday morning by the PNP at his house in Pasig City. Reports say the suspect changed the license plates of his vehicle. The original plates were later found inside his own car. Authorities also recovered a gun. The suspect didn't have a permit to carry.
Investigators recovered one fired cartridge case matching that of a caliber 40. The recovered pieces of evidence were subjected for ballistic at nagmatch po ito. Initial verification revealed that the black Mercedes-Benz with personalized plate number BCS77, ito yung taong bumaril, naka-Mercedes-Benz, is registered to a certain individual residing in Las Piñas, but he can no longer be found in his last known address. Follow-up investigation led to the location of the suspect's residence in Pasig City.
Doon po sa report, no, doon sa nakuha na, yung dalawang baril talaga registered. Meron po silang LTAP. But what's the difference? Wala siya permit to carry. Hindi po authorized po siya ilabas yung baril.
The suspect was said to be a businessman and had no criminal record. Police cite road rage as the likely motive behind the shooting incident.
As to the motive of the incident, kumbaga bakit niya binaril, as of now, per the testimony of one of the living witness, siya mismo yung buhay na nakasakay dun sa Innova mismo. She's telling that merong gitgitan sa kalsada. So that shows yung motive.
The victim's family have formally filed a complaint against the suspect. The 65-year-old victim had only been a stay-in driver for 5 months. The victim's employer promised to assist with the funeral and wake expenses.
Magbigyan ng hustisya yung ginawa nila sa tatay namin. Anagutan mo yung ginawa mo.
The suspect is now detained at the Makati PNP and could face a murder charge. Rayo Capulong, ABS-CBN News.